Did you know that most women have failed to conceive just because they are missing their ovulation day? And why are they missing their ovulation day? It's because they don't know, number one, how to calculate. But again, they cannot know that today is my ovulation day. They don't know the signs and symptoms of ovulation. They cannot look at their body and know, today I am ovulating. In this very video, we'd like to look at the signs and symptoms. What can you see around your body and you get to understand that you are ovulating so that you can plan and have your baby?
Ask Dr. Uthuman on Sawawo.
Hello, my very good viewers. Welcome to Ask Dr. Uthuman YouTube channel, a channel where you learn medicine at the comfort of your living room. I told you, if you'd like to get in touch with me to have a private chat, go to my website www.druthman.com and book an appointment. I'll be right there to chat with you privately. And if it's your very first time to watch this channel, please do not forget to subscribe and also press the notification bell in order to be notified of any videos we upload. And today we are talking about a very important topic which many of you have been bothering me in my inboxes. All my inboxes, all social media handles have been full of these questions. Doctor, when am I ovulating? How do I know that I'm ovulating? Doctor, maybe I don't ovulate. Doctor, I ovulate twice in a month. Now, today's topic, I think, will be able to answer your queries. Number one, what is ovulation? Ovulation is that period of time, is that day when the egg, a mature egg, because remember, a woman has several eggs or several ova in the ovary, and at least one of them will mature at a go. So that matured egg will move. There is that time when it moves from the ovary, that is to say from its sac where it was originally made from, and then it will travel into the fallopian tubes. Why is it going to the fallopian tube? It's waiting for the sperm to be fertilized and you conceive. Now, that day, that egg moves from the ovaries into all to the fallopian tubes is called the ovulation day. Now, most women confuse ovulation with menstruation. Most women think by going to menstruation, you are ovulating. No, some women do not actually ovulate, and that is what we call anovulation. And I will give reasons why some women do not ovulate. But going into your menstruation doesn't automatically mean that you are ovulating. However, normally, when a woman is menstruating normally, then that woman will also ovulate. Now, every woman has a different day they are supposed to ovulate. They are different. It's not it's like not the same to every woman. Some women, actually most of them, will ovulate on the 14th day because most women have a 28-day cycle. So those women with a regular 28-day cycle will ovulate on the 14th day. Women with a 29-day cycle will ovulate on the 15th day. And those with a 35-day cycle will ovulate on the 21st day. However, those women that have the length of the menstrual cycle, whose length of the menstrual cycle is just 21 days, those women will ovulate on the 7th day. Therefore, ovulation will vary from a woman to a woman. And in one of my videos, I taught you how you can calculate the ovulation day, even when your cycle is irregular. And I guess you'll visit that video and check out what I'm talking about. Now, I have said that some women do not ovulate, even when they are menstruating. So what could be the reasons as to why women may not ovulate? And this is what science calls an ovulatory cycle, whereby a woman is menstruating, they have menstruation, but they are not ovulating. So what is this? And some of these women are in their menopause. So number one, these women are in menopause. They are in the premenopause stage. They are about to stop menstruation. When a woman that last year or 2 years, when they're about to end their menstruation or to stop menstruation at around 45 and above, then they'll have an ovulatory cycle. Number two, a woman who is on family planning pills, birth control pills. A woman on birth control pills may not ovulate sometimes. And even those with who are on an implant, which contains levonorgestrel, because those hormones may interfere with the hormone responsible for ovulation, and a woman may not be able to ovulate. Though I'm not saying that whoever is on mens is on family planning doesn't ovulate, but most of them will not ovulate. Now, there is a disease called polycystic ovarian syndrome. We discussed this when I was discussing with Dr. Amarach, and we talked about polycystic ovarian syndrome. So most women with polycystic ovarian syndrome will not ovulate. They're not ovulate, and therefore they will have an ovulatory cycle. Then there are women with premature ovarian failure. With premature ovarian failure, these women will also not ovulate. There are also women with diminished ovarian reserve. Diminished ovarian reserve. What does it mean? Now, a woman is given birth, they are born with all the number of eggs they will use in their life. In other words, by birth, you already have all the ovary, or all the ova you are going to use. All the eggs are already there. And now these eggs go on diminishing, or they go on reducing in number with time. There are several reasons why they may diminish or they may reduce. One, during menstruation or during ovulation, and then some other diseases can cause a reduction in the number of your eggs. Now, a time reaches when the ovary has reduced number of eggs that a woman is not able to have an ovulation. So this is the condition we call diminished ovarian reserve, whereby the reserve is the ovary. The ovary has less number of eggs or less number of ova as compared to the normal. That woman may also not be able to ovulate. The last one I'll talk about here is hormonal imbalance, especially women with a problem with their luteinizing and follicle stimulating hormone. These women will have a problem with ovulation, and therefore if you do not ovulate, of course how will you know that you're not ovulating? I'm going to talk about the signs of ovulation. If you find yourself not having these signs at all, every month you're not feeling anything, you're not having any of these signs, then you should be able to check into your doctor and confirm whether you have an ovulatory cycle. The doctors have their ways of investigating this, and when they understand, they'll get the cause and probably get treatment. Now, this is what brought us here. This is the business. What are the signs of ovulation? Number one, cervical mucus. Cervical mucus. During the time when that day a woman is ovulating, there is a way their mucus changes, the cervical mucus, it changes. This time it will become slippery. It will be, the color will be like egg yolk or egg white. Most people describe it as egg white. And it will also be very slippery. How will you determine this? Because we are talking about egg yolk, slippery, and so on. What you'll do, just put your two fingers there. Put your two fingers and get that fluid. When you get that fluid, for example, you put that fluid here. Try to get part of it using your thumb, like this. And then try get another finger, attach it on your thumb, and then release the two fingers. Now, when you release the two fingers, you'll find that this fluid, the fluid remains there, and it will form something like a thread. Because the normal cervical mucus, the moment you touch in that fluid and then try to spread it using your thumb and a finger, of course it will break. It will break immediately. But with this fluid, with this cervical mucus, when a woman is ovulating, it will be very slippery, and therefore when you touch it, you try to spread, it will remain there up to actually, by the way, a certain distance, and that is one of the major signs of ovulation. The moment you see that sign, just know that, hey, you may be ovulating. Another feature is what we call heightened senses. Heightened senses. What do I mean by heightened senses? Now, during the time of ovulation, a woman, most women become sensitive. Their senses become very sensitive. Which senses? Like the sense of taste and the sense of smell. Mainly those two senses, the sense of taste and the sense of smell, will become very sensitive, whereby you just bring something very small and say, this thing is smelling this. This thing, they have a very high sense of smell, a very high sense of taste. And this is what brings about the craving issues. Find some, a woman wants to eat this, they don't want this. And I'm told there are some women who, during the time of ovulation, who do not even want to, I don't want to go there. But these are things which are happening to many. So during that time, they develop that sense, they are craving. I thought women only crave during pregnancy, but they also crave in this time, during this time. So it's also what we call breast tenderness or sourness. When a woman is, during that time of ovulation, a woman's breast becomes tender and sore. So at times, actually, when you touch it, there is that tingling sensation that is there, and also some pain. It's not, of course, a lot of pain, but if a woman has been observing herself, because there are some women who really feel themselves, they have been observing their bodies, they are able to detect that, this time my breast is a little bit tender, and that could be the time of ovulation. So same thing is about the breast enlargement. During this time also, the breasts try to enlarge a little bit. You know, if you've not been so observant with your breasts, you may not realize that your breast is enlarging. And especially women who have produced several children may not realize that their breasts are enlarging. But for young girls, those who are maybe one child old, they have never had any child, those women whose breasts are still up, they may be able to realize that their breasts are enlarging. So the enlargement is also one of the key factors that will predict for you that you are undergoing ovulation. Now, there is a very important factor also here, that is temperature change, and that is called the basal body temperature. What is basal body temperature? Basal body temperature is measured when you've not yet done anything. Like, you measure it in the morning. When you wake up, you measure your body temperature. That is called the basal body temperature, because it is the temperature when you've not had anything to do. Because when you do something, of course, the body temperature will somehow increase and so on. But the basal body temperature is when you've not done anything. So you wake up in the morning and measure that temperature. Now, how will you be able to know that my temperature has increased? As a woman, if you'd like to understand this, start measuring your temperature every time you wake up in the morning. And now you realize that the day you measure it and it has gone a little bit high, it may be predicting to you that you are undergoing ovulation. However, there are some diseases, even coronavirus, COVID-19, malaria, a lot of diseases can cause an increase in body temperature, but that slight increase, especially of 0.5 to 1 degrees Fahrenheit or 1 degree Celsius, it may be a sign that you are ovulating. Now, some women will tell you that they are spotting. This is strange, because in most times spotting comes during pregnancy or on the second week. I'll be discussing, in my next video, I'll be discussing about the signs of early pregnancy. But also spotting can happen during ovulation. And why is spotting happening during ovulation? Because I told you, during ovulation, a mature egg, a mature ovum, is being released from the ovary into the fallopian tube. Now, that egg is embedded or it's enclosed by the follicle. So now, the follicle has to rupture for the egg to pass through. Now, that rupture is what causes the spotting. It's some slight bleeding. And so if it's too much bleeding, then that is not spotting we are talking about. The other one is just slight bleeding, which can be detected by maybe a woman using a toilet tissue will be able to detect that. So it's not all that serious bleeding. Now, another very important issue here is increase in libido. Now, during this time, actually, I am telling you, this is the time when a woman really wants so much. This is the time when a woman is in need of a man. This is the time when their libido is very high. And for married couples, this is the time you'll find that it's the woman asking for something from the man. So during this time, actually, during the time of the month, when you see yourself really high, you want it. Every time you really feel you should have it, then just get to know that day may be an ovulation day for you. Then the last one I'll talk about, actually it's not the last, there are some other points, but there is another very important factor I'm talking about, is cervical changes. What happens here? This will be detected by a woman who has been observing herself. She will be able to detect cervical changes. And what are these changes? Number one, the cervix will become softer. It will become very, very soft. What are we talking about? When during any other normal day, the cervix is firm or it's hard. How? It's like the tip. When you try to put your fingers there to feel the cervix, when you press it, you feel like it's like the tip of the nose. Everyone who is watching this video, try to feel the tip of your nose. It's firm. It's firm. And that is how the cervix feels on any other normal day. Now, when you try to touch your cervix and it is soft, like the feeling of your lip, try to feel your lip, try to touch your lip. When you touch your lip, it's soft. So if you've been feeling your cervix and it's been like the tip of the nose, but at this time, this day, you feel it, it's like the lip. Just know that it's likely to be your ovulation day. Then again on the cervix, it will go a little bit high. Usually you've been putting your fingers there without any effort and you touch the cervix. But this time you find that you're putting the fingers, you're not able to touch it. You have to push the fingers high up to feel the cervix. Hey, get to understand, it's likely to be your ovulation day. And lastly, on that particular part of the cervical changes is on the opening of the cervix. Normally, the cervix is supposed to be closed, fully closed. Of course, there is some very small space that is there, but not you cannot feel it. Now, when you touch, when you try to feel your cervix and you find that it's somewhere opening, there is a small hole somewhere there, just understand that your cervix, you are in on your ovulation day. And why is it opening? It's opening to allow the sperms to pass through for fertilization. So that when you realize those three changes in the cervix, just know that it's likely to be your ovulation day. Now, another very important factor is saliva fanning. This is very hard to understand, but during ovulation, there is a way your saliva changes. The texture and the whole thing about your saliva changes. Most women will not realize this, but this can be detected if you want to get it clearly. You can detect it using a microscope. So there are microscopes that are able to determine the texture, the shape of your saliva, and it will fan out. It will fan, when it is spread on the microscope slide, it will be able to fan out, and that is also a big sign that you are ovulating. Don't worry about that sign. It is hard to detect, and you may need an expert to do it for you. But there is another is a sign that is abdominal bloating. When you've not been very fine and you've not eaten any strange food, you've been deworming yourself and you find that you're having bloating, it may be a sign that you are ovulating. Now, another one is about swelling of the V and V. The V and V may swell. The V and V may swell. You know, and most of these signs and symptoms we are talking about will be able to... It's only a woman who understands her body that will be able to detect these signs. Because when I talk about swelling, it's not that your V will swell too much, you'll see, no? No, but you'll see that there is a change. There is the way it is trying to bulge. There is a way it is trying to bulge out of the sulcus. And now you'll be able to detect or to think that this is an ovulation day. And then lastly, if you want to confirm that you are ovulating, then you'll be able to use an ovulation kit. There are several ovulation kits on market that use blood, that use urine, and so on. When you do that test and you get two lines, then it will predict for you that is your ovulation day. If it's your very first time to watch this channel, please don't forget to subscribe and also press the notification bell in order to be notified of any important video we upload. And if you'd like to get in touch with me to have a private chat, go to my website www.druthuman.com and book an appointment. We shall be there. We shall chat privately. And you can find us on all our social media platforms. The name is Ask Dr. Uthuman. See you. Ask Dr. Uthuman.